Clark Tun rescues Knots. It all comes down to this. Fourth plays fifth in a pivotal game for the title of the LV County Championship. Yorkshire are off the pace and out of contention, but they can still deny Knots, who suffered a damaging defeat last time. They're the furthest back of the leading group of four. Yorkshire put their hosts into bat, hoping to cause the same kind of carnage Hampshire had last week, but the start was a sedate one, Hamid and Slater building towards 50. Matt Fisher broke the peace, the England opener caught behind looking to cut, and George Hill followed it up, the other opener out in the very next over, by way of a fine nick through to Duke. Duckett and Clark looked to rebuild, but Yorkshire had found a bit of a groove, and with the score up into the 60s, they had another. Hill had his second, Duckett out for seven, and Stephen Mullaney was required much earlier than the captain would have hoped. He steered his side through what remained of the session, the score up to 79 for three at lunch, but it had been far from the start that his side needed. Mullaney took an aggressive approach to his innings after the break. He and Clark fired some quick boundaries off to take their side past that all-important 100-run mark and beyond. They were up to 119 when Code, pushing as hard as he could, got one to pop up on the Knots skipper and bring his cameo to an end for 31 off 41. While around him wickets had tumbled, Joe Clark had survived and fought back against the Yorkshire bowling. With his ninth boundary, his innings came to fruition. 50 runs scored off 96 balls, but he would definitely want more. As before though, his partner couldn't stay with him. Moores rooted to the crease and out, caught behind for 9 off Thompson. Clark looked to be the key wicket, and Yorkshire almost had him, only for Lythe to sell the chance with him on 59. Patterson White wouldn't have the same luck, out for 16 before the break, caught behind off Code. Knots headed in for tea soon after, the score 176 for 6. Clark resumed his impressive innings after the break, and was playing his way to a new season's best. His previous highest total was eclipsed, and 100 runs was now firmly in his sights. He put on a bit of a rescue job, and with it came the 200, calmly reached with a single off Bess. Everson was playing a good supporting role. He was putting the bad balls away to aid the recovery, and firing Brook to the ropes to take the value of the 7th wicket partnership to 50. He was full of confidence. Bess smashed down the ground for 6, the table starting to turn now. Clark wanted a bit of that, and found 6 of his own off Code, a fantastic way for him to go to his first century of the season. Reached of 194 deliveries, featuring 14 fours to go with that towering maximum. He wasn't done though. His partnership with Everson was changing the game. 250 up now for the hosts, who were really showing some fight. Everson too cashed in. 50 runs scored off 97 balls when he picked up 2 off Matt Revis. Another great knock just when his side needed it. But with the milestone came the moment Yorkshire had been hunting for. 3 balls after his partner had 50, Clark had to go for 59. Lythe clung on this time. His earlier drop had cost his side 50 runs. Hutton added 9 with some quick boundaries before he was removed, caught behind by Revis. And there was time for one more. Fletcher out, another for Revis, Knots still 8 shy of 300. That's how they finished the day. Everson and Patterson, the men who'll return to the crease tomorrow morning. They'll hope they can reach that mark quickly and perhaps put on some more. Whatever happens, day 2 is set to be a fascinating tussle in this tight contest for the title.